And welcome, Ms. Wu Hong. Is she here? I give a very brief introduction about her. Angela was born to Beijing opera artist family, and her grandfather and her parents, a very well-known artist. She herself graduated from the National Academy of Chinese Traditional Theater and then served in the National Troupe of Beijing Opera. She became a student of Mr. Mei Baojiu, and we know that Mr. Mei Baojiu is the son of Master Mei Lanfang. Since her moving to the United States, that was more than 20 years ago, Angela has been actively teaching and performing Beijing Opera in different places. So welcome, Angela.
下面一位艺术家将是来自美国大华府地区的吴虹老师。吴虹老师，您好。
您好。
吴虹老师呢是出身于京剧世家，他的祖父是唱花脸的，他的父亲是著名的京剧艺术家、花脸演员吴玉章老师，他的母亲也是一位京剧表演艺术家沙淑英老师。他的先生张远宁也是一位京剧表演艺术家，是学习那个武生的。这个吴虹老师和他的先生张远宁老师都是中国戏曲学院87届毕业生，毕业以后进入中国京剧院。吴虹老师是主攻青衣花山的，并在呢89年拜梅葆玖大师学习梅派，在89和90年两年举办了2次的个人京剧专场。其中《霸王别姬》一戏更是得到了梅葆玖先生的亲自指导。90年代来到美国以后，虽然不能以京剧表演作为职业，但是20几年来也是坚持登台演出和传授京剧。吴虹老师，您今天给观众们展示的第一段曲目是什么呢？
今天的第一段展示的曲目是《大保国》，因为是敬我父亲80岁诞辰了，我呢为了感谢我的父母养育之恩、教育之恩和扶持之恩，那么我为大家献演这个《大保国》，这是在专场演出的时候，第一出《战金山》，第二出《大保国》，第三出是卖水，第四出是《霸王别姬》其中的一出，请大家欣赏，谢谢。
Yeah.
精彩的表演。当年吴红老师演出这折戏的时候应该只有二十岁出头，真是非常的功夫非常的棒。更值得纪念的是这个大宝国当中的花脸，就是吴红老师的父亲，著名京剧表演艺术家吴玉章老师，真是难得的记忆，父女同台呢，实为罕见。那么接下来呢，吴红老师将为我们演唱一段梨花颂。梨花颂呢是他非常喜爱的一段曲目，也经常在我们美国的舞台上表演。他今天跟我讲，他说他不仅是他喜欢，每次演出的时候，那些对中国文化毫无兴趣的孩子们听了以后也都非常喜欢，这充分的说明了梨花颂的感染力和梨花颂的魅力。吴红老师呢，自从来到美国以后呢，也是一直致力于培养下一代京剧的人才。为了让我们这次节目更加出色，吴红老师呢特地的将这个梨花颂的曲子改写成古筝曲，由他的大女儿张瑞华来伴奏，吴红老师自己清唱，然后呢他的二女儿张瑞琪粉墨登场，同吴红老师和他姐姐张瑞华同时演出。只是呢网络技术特别的有限，母女三人同镜的这个愿望不能实现，所以他们将这个节目呢分了好几段来录制。那么我们呢就将这个他的节目用视频和 PPT 做了一结合。现在呢就请大家欣赏吴红老师母女三人合作的《梨花颂》。
We just watched two video clips from Ms. Wu Hong, Angela. The first one we watched was her performance in Da Bao Guo with her father as the other leading role. It is truly an invaluable piece that shows the cooperation between a father and a daughter. So I like it very much. And the second one was about the song, The Old Two Pear Blossom, that one we just talked about with Mr. Wong Sze. He is the lyricist So this is the theme song of the Noble Council of Great Tang. And what you just watched is the combination, is the cooperation among Wu Hong herself, Angela herself, and her two daughters. It is a very unique one, but we still, you know, if those people, you listened to our talk about this theme song, and now you just listen to this song, and it's really a beautiful song. And Wu Hong Lao, thank you very much for your wonderful performance.
现在呢，我要再次将张晶老师和吴红老师请出，来到我们镜头前面。他们几位老师呢，都是活跃在京剧舞台上多年的京剧表演艺术家，也现在又是从事这个京剧教学。 既有丰富的表演经验，又有丰富的教学经验，所以呢，我这里想请几位老师和我们观众分享一下他们对京剧人才培养的一些感受。那么，我们第一位老师来谈感受的将是吴红老师。Cynthia, could you please do translation?
So we have the three of them, Miss Zhang Jing, Professor Zhang Jing, Miss Qin Xueling, and Angela with us, because we wanted them to have a discussion on the topic of the future of training skill for Beijing opera performers. So we would like to listen to their sharing. So I think the first, Angela, you can go first.
好，你们好。我觉得呢，在华府京剧是一个 纵向的文化，怎么说呢？因为它比较强调它的有创造思维，它是讲一个广度。那咱们中国的京剧呢，他们是一个横向的文化，他们是比较深，比较 professional， 就是我们讲的是很专业。那么在这边呢，虽然我们演出的时候没有办法像中国这么原汁原味的。 那么我们只是在这个演出和教学当中呢，看小朋友他们有什么各种各样的特长，他们的兴趣。那么主要是我们起一个撒种的作用，对这个弘扬民族文化呢，给他们做一个播种，希望他们能够发挥出他们的潜力，还能够发现他们以后有什么的创造能力。 我们是这边的教学是针对小孩来讲是这样，那么请秦老师再讲，他跟我母亲教的成年人比较多。
So Angela, her students mostly is kids, young kids. And when she teaches those kids, because she knows that those kids come to her already has some kind of training or talent, either in playing instruments or singing. So as a teacher, she would just adapt the original Beijing opera piece and in order to meet their needs, not really just teach exactly the 100% authentic Beijing opera. Even though, you know, she has to change a little bit, but she feels that it's important like just to develop, help students develop interest in the traditional culture. That is the significant thing she's doing, and she feels it's pretty important. So next one, I would like to have Ms. Zhang Jing. And Zhang Jing 教授，请您跟我们 share 一下，就是您是怎么样的看法？
您是说我在教学方面是吧？就是我们对京剧人才培养的前景。 京剧人才培养前景，我觉得，因为我多年呢是从事这个，那就是专业人才吧，这个学生们的培养，譬如对本科生、研究生的培养，那么我觉得呢，实际上现在的年轻人，他们能够潜下心来，全身心的投入这么一门传统的艺术，我觉得非常不容易，他得抛出很多的诱惑与干扰。 将来的人才，我觉得是应该是越来越稀缺，越来的越顶尖。那么留下来的绝对是真正好的，那么就差一点的，他自己就优胜劣汰了。这是对专业人才。那么我们戏剧学院呢，他培养人才，他是怎么说呢？是全国各个艺术院校里选择这些出类拔萃的艺术新苗。
进来，那么也是找最具有啊艺术造诣最高的啊造诣高的这些老艺术家，还有是啊教授们来传授啊艺术，那、各个流派等等。那么他们通过譬如本科也是四年，研究生三年啊，甚至更多，有明星班呢，研究生班等出来以后，他们几乎都在各个院团啊，中国京剧院、北京京剧院等等啊，其他全国各地成为挑梁的，也就是目前活跃在舞台上的，还有一些也我的学生都成教授了啊。那么说他们将来担任着历史的重任，以后的人才培养呢，在专业方面我觉得国家也会给予更大的扶持。譬如现在这些学生呢，他是免学费的啊，那么打入校中专开始就国家免学费，那一直到本科生毕业，研究生呢实际上学费也是象征性也没有那么多，所以国家那么提倡传统文化，我觉得将来的人才培养呢我觉得会普遍培养重点提高啊。另外呢，我从除了这个方面之外，我们学院也在这个戏曲进校园啊，在各大中小学包括清华北大，那我的学生都在清华北大，也先在那里也去招一些特长生，譬如有一段是说你京剧特长就会给你加分啊，就跟你弹钢琴过了几级给你加分，京剧也有考级啊，那么加分呢可能高考说加40分甚至加60分啊，他这个那么就促进了很多学生家长来找我啊，因为我现在也负责梅兰芳艺术基金会的工作，所以他们就希望有那么一些机构来培养自己的孩子，觉得在学校学习啊，那课后那一小时已经不够了，你是不是能够一些老师给我们单独的在加课，我们要在艺术上提高。后来在一些
Thank you very much, and I'm sorry because of the time sake. Okay, so I give just a very brief introduction what Miss Professor Zhang Jing just said. She thinks she's a teaching professional performers, and she feels that for those students right now in today's society, it's very hard for them to really stay focused because there are so much temptation around them.And those people, they can graduate from the school, usually are the best performers. And when they go to different Beijing opera troupes, they are the leading roles there. And also right now, she's pretty happy to see that the government has been doing a lot to support the training of Beijing opera performers by giving different kind of incentives or the policy which helps those students, like give them freestudy at a college, and they will have the good, very good teachers to teach them. So she feels that it should be pretty bright of the future of having a good Beijing opera performers. So now I just invited Miss 秦雪玲 to share her thought. So 秦老师您可以讲一讲。
金花好，还有广大听众观众朋友们好啊，我这个舞台不是，我这艺术生涯60多年吧，有十几年的时间演出，30多年的时间都是在教学，所以呢也确实有很多的心得体会吧。首先是我原来在中国戏剧学院做老师的时候，那都是培养专业的学生，专业的学生呢就是要因材施教，特别是作为老师也应该是一个非常好的伯乐，学生教给你的他
打断您一下，您可不可以讲一下，就是说您怎么看这个将来，就是未来这个前景是怎么样培养，是培养戏曲演员的前景会是怎么样？
培养戏曲演员的前景啊，我觉得实际上呢咱们现在的这个市场啊就是在国内也不是太好啊，这个大家虽然都非常的努力，但是呢因为现在的娱乐呀，特别现在自媒体出现了，就是自娱自乐的形式更突出了，所以呢我觉得专业演员的演出的机会也会少，同时呢演出的时候的观众也会少。为什么这些年那个 相声能够特别的那些小品能够特别受欢迎，也就是我们那些文化大革命之后那些年的那个特别严肃的，特别那个政治性比较强的，就是搞了很多年了，所以一下改革开放了，所以这些都起来了。现在呢，我们又开始提倡这个国学文化，让要求我反正在我们团里边很多老师退了休以后，在家也没事儿，都到各个大中小学都去教学生普及京剧艺术，我觉得这个对于将来那个京剧艺术的传承和人才的培养是一非常重大的举措，京剧是不会灭亡的。
Yes, thank you, Miss Ching, and I'm sorry that I have to cut you. 很抱歉，我要那个打断你，就是因为时间的关系。那 Miss Ching, she is not very optimistic about the future of training Beijing opera performance. Even in China, the situation is not that good. So her opinion is different from Professor Zhang Qing, what we just listened to. Because right now, professional performers, they do not have that much opportunity to go on stage to give performance, and they do not have a large group of audience to watch their performance. So what she can say that right now, many of her friends, the professional, the retired professionals, right now they go to different places that go to the elementary school, middle school, and they wanted those little kids to know more about the Beijing opera. She think that is the very good thing to do because you are giving the helping those kids at a very young age to understand what is Beijing opera. And this is kind of you have the seed, you know, everywhere, and I hope those seed will generate someday when they grow up. So thank you very much, three of our artists, and for sharing your opinion.